This video will illustrate the product of a fraction times a fraction in ways that will help students discover a rule for finding such products. It will also provide an intuitive understanding of multiplying one fraction by another. A family has a 1/3 acre lot, the shaded amount of this bar, behind their house and considers planting a garden on 1/2 of this lot. The garden will be what fraction of an acre? So we're going to divide this lot in half. We'll put the garden on this path. And we'll write down the fractions. 1/2 of 1/3. Now there are several ways to find this the amount occupied by the garden. We could use another bar that has the same shaded amount. 1 part out of 6. 1/6 acre. Or we could continue by splitting the other parts of this bar so that we have 6 equal parts. 1 part shaded also gives us 1/6 of an acre. Now when multiplying whole numbers, say 3 times 4, this means 3 of the 4s. Similarly, when multiplying fractions, 1/2 of 1/3, we write this as 1/2 times 1/3. Suppose a second family has a 1/2 acre lot, represented by this bar that has 1 part out of 2 shaded, and they're thinking about planting a garden on 1/3 of this lot. Their garden will be what fraction of an acre? So again, we take our water-based pen, and this time we divide this into 3 equal parts, roughly. And we'll put the garden on this part right here. So here's 1/3 of this lot that's behind their house. And we record what we've done. 1/3 of 1/2. Now to determine how big this part is with regard to the whole bar, we can find another bar that has the same shaded amount. In this case, it's also 1/6. Or we can use a water-based pen here and divide this part into 3 equal parts. Now the bar has 6 equal parts and the garden is on 1 of those parts. And that also is another way of showing that the garden is on 1/6. So this is 1/6 acre. And as before, we can write 1/3. Times 1/2 equals 1/6. Possibly continue with these little reminders that by multiplying we're taking 1/3 of 1/2. With these two illustrations, we've shown that 1/2 times 1/3 is equal to 1/3 times 1/2 because they both equal 1/6. And it's interesting that the commutative property for multiplication holds here. Because in one case, the illustration, we took 1/2 of a 1/3 bar, and in the second case, we took 1/3 of the shaded amount of a 1/2 bar. The second family now decides that they need a bigger garden. So they will use 2/3 of their 1/2 acre lot for the garden. This larger garden will be what fraction of an acre? So let's write down what we want to do here. We want 2/3 of 1/2. The 3 down here indicates we're going to break this into 3 equal parts, and the 2 means we're going to take 2 of them. So we'll divide this into 3 equal parts, and we're going to take 2 of them. So these double shaded areas now are going to be the area occupied by the garden, and we can just continue to divide the unshaded parts here into 3 equal parts. So we've got 6 parts, and here we have 2 of those parts shaded. So the garden is going to occupy 2/6 acre. And we could also show that this is 1/3. So we wanted to write that in lowest terms. We could write 1/3 acre. Writing this equation using the time signs, we have 2/3 times 1/2 equals 2/6. Or 1/3. Let's look at one more example. Suppose a recipe calls for 3/4 cup of blueberry juice and you wish to cut the recipe in half. What fraction of a cup of blueberry juice will be used? Let's record what we're trying to do here. I want to take 1/2 of 3/4. Now one way to do this is to take 1/2 of each 1/4. So we could cut this 1/4 in half, take half of that. We'll cut this 1/4 in half, take half of that. Cut this 1/4 in half and take half of it. Cutting this empty unshaded part in half, we've now got 8 parts, and we're going to be taking 3 of those parts. So this equation gives us 3/8. And writing the multiplication using the time sign, 1/2 times 3/4 equals 3/8. Now another way to think about this, we have this 3/4 of a cup of blueberry juice. We could cut this right in half. That would mean cut the total shaded amount right in half. And so half of that is going to be 1/4 and 1/2, which is 1/8. So again, we get 3/8 for 1/2 of 3/4. These are the 4 products we've illustrated. Let's just separate these. Take 1/2 of something or 1/3 of something will help students to make sense out of multiplying fractions. By looking at these products they have illustrated, students will be able to see how the product of 2 fractions can be obtained. We multiply numerator by numerator and multiply denominator by denominator. This is one of the easiest of the rules for fraction operations. The Tao of Bas mat has some patterns involving products of fractions. We can see that 1/2 is greater than 1/3, but how much greater is it? Now this center line can be extended down here. We can cut this third right here in half, and so this amount right here, when added on to 1/3, is going to equal 1/2. So what we see visually here is that 1/2 is equal to 1/3 plus 1/2 of 1/3. Next, let's compare 1/3 and 1/4. Now we can see that 1/3 is greater than 1/4, and the question again is how much greater is it? If we extend this line down here, this might be 1/3 of 1/4 right here. 1/3 would equal 1/4 plus 1/3 of 1/4. So we could write that 1/3 equals 1/4 plus 1/3 times 1/4. Writing the next equation would be 1/4 equals 1/5 plus 1/4 of 1/5. Students might want to continue this pattern and do the computation to see if both sides of each equation are equal. NCTM's Principles and Standards for School Mathematics has the following statement. From their experience with whole numbers, many students develop the belief that multiplication makes bigger and division makes smaller. When students solve problems in which they need to decide whether to multiply or divide fractions and decimals, such beliefs can have negative consequences. If students see illustrations and word problem applications of multiplying by a fraction less than 1, they will have a better understanding of why such products make smaller. For example, 2/3 of a committee of 18 members attended a meeting. In the fraction 2/3, the denominator 3 tells us that we want to divide this set into 3 equal parts. And the 2 tells us we're going to take 2 of those parts. We've got 1 part here. We've got 1 part here. So we've got 2 of those parts. And so 2/3 of 18 is 6 plus 6, 12.